We're good to go. It's live.
Okay. All right, we're good. So welcome to the Better Late Than Never podcast, guys. I'm your host, Warfare, here with McDealy once again. Tonight we have a few guests. We have Mr. Jendrek. We got Hammer Moose, obviously. He's wearing a shirt this time, so no worries. And then we have Fat Clemenza, who's going to come on once he resolves his internet issues, if all goes well. Tonight we're going to talk about a few topics. You can see them down the bottom if you're interested in... you know, thinking of some stuff to talk about before we start. But first things first, let's talk about the whole trial by combat. So, Ham, have you ever done trial by combat for someone when you're playing APD?
Never done that before.
Okay, are you familiar with what it is, basically?
I'm assuming it's obviously the guy gets to fight somebody else to see who gets away.
Yeah, yeah. So I'll explain it real quick. What works for me, I have a certain stipulation on it. If someone's RPing a situation and they are the kind of person that likes to just pull out unicorns to justify whatever action the APD are talking about, you know what I mean? Like, well, you killed like 15 guys, so you're a serial killer. Oh no, I'm a black belt in karate, and like when 15 guys surrounded me with that Mark 200s, it took all of them to try and restrain me to get me down, and then I butterfly chopped him with my pinky finger and killed them all in self-defense. You know, that kind of stuff. It's like, alright, well, you're going to RP. You're not RPing for the sake of RP. You're RPing just to get out of a ticket, and you're going to go as far as you're going to go to do it. So in that situation, I say, okay, well, we have a different way of solving this problem. We have a trial by combat system. If and what it is for me, the way I set it up is we'll give each party, if as APD, I can fight for the APD or I can pick someone to represent me. Criminal can do the same thing. He can fight for himself or he can get someone to represent him. The dualies are issued PO7s. They can't use a vest. They start back-to-back with their pistol in a low-rated position. They walk, and after a shot is fired, they both turn around and start shooting. Whoever, it's best 2 out of 3. Whoever, if the criminal wins, they get a pardon. If the if the APD win, they get a full ticket.
So the question is now, do you think that's a valid option for certain criminals? Would you do it yourself if, you know, you had a chance to do it? Basically, I'm wondering, would you do it yourself if you, you know, would you think that'd be a valid way to go about it?
Well, honestly, I probably wouldn't do that. I mean, that's it's a cool idea and all, but honestly, if they're caught. Being a black belt, you're not going to take out 15 people. Not like that.
I know.
But to me, though, they're both RPing it, though. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, yeah. if the criminal's agreeing to it, the RP of this of the deal, then it's not really a is it wrong or right. Personally, yeah, I wouldn't do it because I'm a crap shot. So
that's why you pick somebody else to fight for you.
Oh, that's true. I get a bot Kratos to do it.
You just have Moob do it, and then if you lose, he'll just blame it on like all the problems he had before, and then you just keep having him redo it until he finally wins.
There you go.
Yes!
No. You call Virus to be your shot. That's all you gotta do.
I mean, is there a question, has it been brought up that you shouldn't be doing this?
No, there's one that came from, actually.
I've never heard of it saying no against it, to be honest with you.
I've never heard anyone say, no, you can't do this, yes, you can do it. So, I mean, I guess it's like one of those gray area type things where it's like, well, technically, you know, it's something you could do.
Right. Any ticket is, as far as the rules go, any ticket is pardonable if the guy RPs it properly, and the cop says, yeah, it's pretty good RP, we can pardon the ticket. Right?
Yeah.
Sure.
I mean, correct me if I'm wrong, Ham, but...
yeah, you can do that.
Yeah, I mean, if he has val... if because we've done that before. I know when we used to do Heli Patrol with Ace, we'd pull people over with, back in the days, 500,000 was a huge ticket.
Right.
And we'd pull people over, and if they RP'd the crap out of it with us, we're laughing our asses off, we'd pardon them, you know, because it was like the best RP session we ever had.
Yeah.
And so, I mean, same scenario here. If they go up for that, if I was a better shot, I'd do it.
You should like practice and just be the best around, and then every time someone like does some crappy RP, you're like, all right, trial by combat. Just know you'll win every single time. There's not much we can really discuss about this. I was just wondering everyone's opinion whether or not they agreed with having it be an option for people to do. Obviously, we wouldn't want it to be something that people can just kind of like ask for, like in terms of, you know, oh, I want to hire up. You can't really say, oh, I want trial by combat.
Yeah,
then everyone's going to be doing it. Yeah, little Larry with this $400 ticket is going to be asking for it. So
I might actually try that. I might try that on somebody if I find them in the RP.
It's fun. Really, I do it a few times.
You can either go to jail or tribal combat. Which one do you want? I think it's funny, especially when everyone gets mad at the end of it and they're raging because either they just did horrible or like one person just did like the craziest shit and just took them out like it was nothing.
Yeah.
Any final comments on this short-lived topic? I mean, anything little to say about it?
No.
Nothing? All right, so...
I'm definitely going to try it out.
Give it a go. Let us know how it works out for you. So what I want to talk about, because Genjack is here, is regarding the war zone. So it just got added. The idea was to have cartels, and then it wasn't an official thing, but then all of a sudden Poseidon came out of left field and kind of just did it. Like, there was just no discussion of it. He just did the crap. Is there any plans to add anything other than cartels? You know, do you have ideas to expand the cartel system? You know, what are your thoughts on it?
Right now, I think he's just trying to work the kind of the foundation of it. You know, get the coding in there for that. I know when we first talked about the Warzone Island, we originally talked about capturable points that would unlock a vendor to give us more. You know, to give you access to like to different weapons or gear, vehicles, whatever, that aren't on the server already. So I know that is still on the horizon for maybe a release in the future. But right now we're kind of just trying to lay the groundwork of some gang-on-gang wars. Because that's from where we came from, the original founders of Olympus, the server that we came from, that was some of the best time we had was gang-on-gang. It wasn't about gang-on-APD. It was always civ-on-civ interactions that we had the most fun with. You know, the APD was almost a third wheel to everything. You know, we were like, oh, there's the cops. Yeah, we might have to deal with them, but we really got to deal with this gang because that's the real threat, was the other gang. And we had more fun with Civ on Civ versus Civ as opposed to Civ versus cop.
Or just trolling the cops, basically.
Yeah. So that, honestly, this update with the Warzone, with the Warzone is just for the groundwork of what we can do. Because I know that was something he wanted to do, was looking at actually unlocking, you know, unlockable vendors to get access to different gear. And that's something that we want to see, like the new DLC that's going to come out, the Sniper DLC. Not that I'm alluding to there's going to be Sniper rifles on the server, because that's a big... A lot of people want it.
But
you know,
Jen, it's Moose's forte.
Oh my god, I know, right? So a lot of people want it, but how do you RP killing somebody from two clicks away?
It doesn't work. I don't know what you'd even add though for special vendors either. Because think about it, what guns do we not have in the server? We don't have the Zephyr, we don't have the snipers, we don't have various RPGs.
Well, see, they're gonna put. I think either somebody told me or somebody was just theory crafting that they were gonna have shotguns.
I think that was theory crap. We were talking about it before, and we said that'd be so cool if they had a shotgun. You could just be an APD member and bust him.
Poseidon acted like he read that somewhere on a dev branch or something.
I wish we had shotguns. Yeah. Oh my god!
If they have shotguns, but that's gonna be released to everybody.
You know, it's APD breaking doors down with shotguns.
Oh my god! Yeah, that would be it.
It's all about it all the time.
Flared every time, yeah.
But as far as what there's, the DLC's got to offer more than just sniper rifles. I would hope.
Unless it's just adding sniper rifles and more long-range weapons like the MK18. I mean, marksman, you think of marksman, I'm thinking long-range stuff, you know, nothing like submachine guns or shotguns or anything. Even though I think they honestly just need to have, like, a weapons DLC where they're like, here's 15 new weapons, have fun. Because armor doesn't have that many in terms of, like, civilian weapons or at least non, you know, crazy-ass weapons, I guess you'd say.
See, that's what we're hoping, since it's, even though it's just called marksman, we're hoping it's, because it's marksman, it's tied more just with the weapon, so it's a huge weapon DLC. That's what we want to see. So we're kind of waiting for that to come in before we see if we can, if we actually do want to go down the route of an unlockable base.
So
you know what they don't have in the game for weapons? They don't have either of the 45 caliber pistols. And I don't know about you guys, but those pistols are all. I would use those pistols.
I still want the flare gun.
The what?
The flare gun or the cap
gun. The flare
gun,
the starter pistol?
Yeah, a little starter pistol. Like, we were messing around with it before when we were thinking of stuff for the community team, like what they should wear and stuff like that. And it's a fun little thing. We use it on a different server, too. It doesn't do any damage, I don't think. And it's just another little thing to add in there. But I think we did determine it was DLC only, right? Like the go-kart DLC or some crap. It had, like, the little go-kart helmet next to it.
Yeah. Yeah, it's part of the cart DLC.
Yeah,
because it's literally what the race starter would shoot to start the race.
Okay, that's the point of it, I guess.
That's why it's on that, yeah.
So,
because that's what it's called. It's called starter pistol.
That flare, doesn't mean it's flare gun pistol forever for me. It's going to be called a flare gun.
Yeah, starting the race. So.
Okay, so speaking with cartels still, right now they are open fields, right? Like, most of the stuff, it's kind of like an open field type thing of where they're placed.
Mm-hmm.
Did you move them?
No. Poseidon told me about that yesterday. So I started moving stuff around. So they're actually all moved. They're either in like an enclosed area. If it's a broken down building, they're in the broken down building, or they're centered around a set of buildings.
Okay.
So it's not just going to be you standing in a field trying to capture a flag. There's actually going to be
cover
and tactical areas you can hide and stuff like that.
Yeah,
so,
that was going to be a problem with it. I was like, well, you know, it's all fine and dandy that, you know, we can do this, but it's like I'm going to be standing in a field for, what is it, 20 to 30 minutes, and it's like I'm fucked.
Oh, yeah.
There's no one getting out of that.
The only one, I think they all got moved, except the only one that didn't get moved was whatever is in the middle. The meth one is in the middle?
I think meth's left.
Whichever one's in the middle. There's one in the middle that's by the ruins, the broken down castle looking ruins.
Yeah. That might be
but that one,
heroin.
Yeah, even that one is it's in a little broken down building. Like, the walls are busted down, but there's still, one of the walls is up, and you can get cover around the other side.
Yeah, I know you moved the frog one from the little island down there, and you moved it up.
I didn't move that.
Oh, Poseidon
moved it? Poseidon
moved
it across over to the bungalow
about. Bungalow, damn.
Yeah. He moved it over there to the lighthouse. The reason being is because we actually moved in the war zone line.
Mm-hmm.
To exclude those two islands, because he's going to create on the event menu like a last man standing Hunger Games type deal, and that's it'll take place. Actually, there's three different islands it'll take place on. That's those two are one of the two we can choose from.
Okay, so they're using the Spawn Island or whatever it's even called.
The Debug Island.
Yeah, but that's what he used before. I know that.
So that'll be one of them, and then those two little ones down there, I think. So it'll be something where we can actually teleport people over there, and we'll have crates with gear in it and stuff like that for the event.
That's cool. Have any of you guys actually looked at the map yet and seen, you know, the cartels and stuff like that? I mean, obviously me and Jendrick have, we've looked at it before, but have you guys actually gone onto the server and see what they're like, or if they're any
good? I jumped on it as soon as it came out, but when I got on there was nobody online, so I couldn't, you know, go down there and really look too hard into it. I did check out the little rebel outpost. It looked pretty cool.
I haven't got a chance to check it out myself. I've been working a lot this week, but yeah, I'll probably check it out tonight or tomorrow at least.
Yeah, I think he's got the new patch on the dev server. I think.
They removed. I know that. Only thing I'm thinking is I don't even know if that boat shop's going to be used now, because the whole point of the boat shop was because you were going to use that little island, and now it's not on the little island. Is there actually a point to the boat shop?
You can move up. The heroin cartel is up in that top left little peninsula.
Oh, okay.
So,
well, I guess it from there. Has a purpose.
I don't know. There's no reason. I mean, if I can remove it, but it's not hurting anything to be in there.
Okay. I mean, that's what I didn't know. You know, more things on the map, if that affects anything or not.
No.
Submarine!
It gives the rebels access to one more boat shop that they didn't have before.
And then everyone complains, there's no boat shop.
Yeah.
Even though boats are pointless, we can all agree on that.
Hey, I like my sub.
Hey, have you got a boat and souped it up?
I had to push it before we actually had an upgrade spot, so I drove it onto the water and pushed its ass all the way to terminal, and I upgraded. I died probably 26 times. The medic left every single time I died. He didn't want to wait there for me. It's like I'd die, and then 4 seconds later I'd die again, and he'd have to drive all the way back. It's like, yo, just stay here.
That's why you find a medic with a Hemet, man. That's what I did with my sub.
Oh, can they tow it?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Just had him tow it over there? Yep.
Yep. We RP'd it as a big bomb in the back of a sub, and we had to go defuse it at the air service shop.
Jesus. Oh, there you go.
Wow.
It works, I guess.
Well, I like the boat souped up now, except that I did pop willies in them.
they did it before, too, though, at least to a point. I know the only issue I have with boats is, like, every time we'd, like, turtle poach with them, they'd always sink. And I don't know why. Like, we wouldn't hit anything, but it's like after you put the turtles in, it's like, all right, you're fucked. Enjoy
what?
Yeah, it always sank on everyone, so whatever. Boats forever suck, in my opinion, until we have some kind of, like, water oil rigs or something that you do.
They were useful for
that prison. Sounds dope now, so we should mark that somewhere. Oil rigs.
We will.
Oil rigs? Yeah.
Well, I don't know about oil rigs, because we tried that in the past, but that's on my to-do list.
Something in the water.
We will have, I am going to use, there's too much water real estate for us not to use it, so I will have something out in the water to do.
Well, hopefully it's cool shit and not turbo poaching.
So, about the war zones, do you capture, like, a flag, kind of like Kang House, or do you have just players in the area, and then they capture that way?
It's proximity.
Awesome, okay,
it's proximity-based, cool. So, and the way it's designed is, the more people you have that are in the same gang, up to 3 people, it actually speeds up the capture process.
So it's instead of, right now it's 15 minutes to neutralize, 15 minutes to capture for yourselves. You have to fully cap it in order to get the perks for it. However, you have the 3 people, then it becomes 10 minutes to neutralize and 10 minutes to cap. So,
yeah.
Well, now, if it hasn't changed, that is.
Now, with the 3 people there, how is it, say I have like 10 people there and it gets contested, say 2 or 3 guys come into the zone, has it slow it down or?
Right now, if anybody out of your gang comes in the zone, it stops the timer where it's at.
Yeah,
so he did say he's going to work in the future of it slowing it down, depending on, you know, if one gang has 3 guys and the other gang has 1, it just slows the number down because you're still outnumbering it. But right now, if anybody from another gang comes in there, it stops it where it's at. It doesn't reset it or anything. It just stops it where it's at until you eliminate the threat. But the capture point is only, I wanted to say he only said 50 or 60 meters.
So not big at all.
So it's not huge. Yeah, you have to still hold the actual area around the flag. You can't be, you know, within sniping distance and holding the point.
Vermin master race.
Right. There you go.
Just spray everywhere with it. I'm pretty sure with cars, too. I think he talked about it. I think you can. Can you cap it in cars? I don't remember.
No. The second you get in the car, it stops it.
Oh, awesome.
I can't remember. How does that work, though, with, like, 50 cows and stuff? Because I asked him this question, and I just completely forgot what he said.
He,
like,
said somebody has to be outside. I was on there when you asked him the question.
Are you?
You can have somebody in the back of the 50 cow, but you still have to have somebody on the ground.
Okay, that's what it was. Okay. So no plans currently, though, for what you might add other than cartels, if cartels will be the only thing that's down there?
No, just like I said, right now it's just ground. We're just building the frame.
Okay.
Yeah, we're just building the frame.
Well, what we can do is we can move on to community video of the week then. We're kind of like blowing through all the shit, but, you know, every topic right now seems to be like this, like, easy, like, cut and dry, you know, couple minute thing. Has anyone actually seen, other than myself, Jendrak, and McDilly, the Cops episode 1 video? Altus Cops or Olympus Cops, whatever you called it?
I have not watched it yet.
You haven't watched it?
Need to watch it.
Good.
Let's just say I think it's going to be a long running series as long as Supply Box actually keeps up with it. When he first told me he was going to do it, I was like, oh man, this idea is really cool sounding, but can he actually make it cool? Like, you know, I just picture, like, everyone standing around just talking and stuff and it being like the most boring thing, but when I watched it, I was thoroughly, and, you know, liking it. I'm hoping we get more of it. It's the kind of stuff I think we want with the community team.
Oh yeah. He's obviously watched Cops before. So
yeah. He did a good job. Hours of Cops. He's like, alright, I gotta do this.
He didn't even use all the footage either. Like, there was some other stuff where he was there for where we had some pretty awesome footage that we gathered. So he's already got stuff for the next episode that he hasn't used for the first one, so I'm excited.
I think he said he has, like, 3 hours of footage or some crap like that, and he'd, like, spliced them down really small. He was going to make it, like, a longer one, and I was like, nah, just make them really short to the point. No one's going to want to sit there and watch a half-hour video. I mean, you can't make it that cool.
Yeah, 15-minute thing is good.
Yeah,
he didn't
know that. As long as the stuff stays with it and it seems cool, it's going to be nice. He wants me to hop on tomorrow, and we're going to do, like, a solo type thing where I'm going to drive around. I'm hoping with that, and then on top of with the potential news team stuff coming in the game, we're going to see some really cool stuff. As long as people seem to understand the rules and not murder us the second we walk into a red zone.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
We will probably get murdered in red zones.
It's going to happen. It's going to happen.
All right. They wanted the blue vest, and then they'll try to exploit it, and then it just won't work. Honestly, I don't think there's many other videos other than that posted this week, honestly. It's the only one I saw. Did you guys see any other kind of videos that you'd want to shout out and talk about for a second?
I know there was some stuff posted, but I'm not sure.
I only saw the You're Getting Banned video, and the Cops video, that was it. You getting banned video was not entertaining.
Oh, the Squeaker Fest?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Yeah, that was...
Everything else is screenshots.
Everything else is screenshots. I guess we'll move on then. I mean, like I said, we're blowing through this shit like it's nothing. What we'll talk about, I guess, next will be in regards to the economy wipe, and more so like what you would adjust for the economy in order to improve it. If any of you guys saw Poseidon's stream, he was tweaking with what everything would cost. I'm going to set a scenario here. It's something that we were talking about, but it's not like these are set prices or anything like that, and Ginger can tell you the same thing. But he wants to raise prices of loadouts and then make it so you get less money when you run a drug. So, what did you say? It was 40... The current one that it was, like, looked at with was, what, 44K for 50?
That's for one person, yeah. So,
for 50, you make 44,000.
With the carry-all, yeah, it'd be 50 Coke you'd make 44,000 from it.
Yeah, so... Definitely a drastic drop from what we're used to.
Yeah.
Only thing
to
I'm
put
concerned...
in perspective, that's a backpack load, a Hammett load. So it's 440,000 for a Hammett load of coke.
Which is obviously better in that perspective. But the only thing I'm concerned about is if we do lower the amount you make on drugs, and obviously it's like a drastic drop. Because I think 500 Coke sells for what currently? What's the max price for Coke on the current servers? It's like 43?
It's like 43, yeah. So right now, I suppose with 44K with 50, a backpack load, it's about 75% less than you normally make.
Yeah, because you make close roughly 2.1 mil is what you'd make if we're basing off current what you get. So the only thing that concerns me is if we do increase the price on loadouts and we, you know, lower the amount you get, although it would help people like getting this mass amount of money, you're still gonna have that one. You know, I think the cops are literally gonna run shit, and it's because no one's gonna be able to afford the weapons they're gonna need to actually be able to fight off the cops if they do come in the red zones, and then the cops are gonna keep checking the red zones all the time because they know people are gonna be trying to make money. And then on top of that, if you lower legal prices, like I don't want the game to be a grind fest because you want to have that bit of fun. And if things are lowered too much and you don't make money enough to where you can actually have fun every once in a while, I don't know if it's gonna be a good thing.
But I think that's the thing, is that you don't make so much money, right, that you can just have this loadout every time. But I feel like 44K per backpack, Hemet, you said something like 440. I mean, that's a couple of loadouts. I think that's pretty good, you know, if that's your own Hemet. I think.
Well, let me put it in perspective of this. What we're trying to do, and I know exactly what Poseidon's trying to do with this. Is he's trying to make it to where instead of one man makes 2 million or, you know, $3 million. Let's say your goal is to make $3 million. One man could do that, you know, with one Mohawk run or two Hemet runs. Whereas it takes 6 Hemets to do that with the new prices. Well, 7 if you want to break the 3 million mark, okay? That means your gang actually has to get together and run it together.
Yeah.
It means you have to have 7 people to drive, at least 7 people to drive the Hemets. More if you want, you know, passengers and back up and cover and stuff like that. So that's what we're trying to get it to. It's so where gangs actually do something actually do something more than just troll the cops.
Versus just solo runs. I like the concept in theory. I just think that the first couple weeks are going to be, oh, Johnny's doing coke in his little SUV with his Rook. We're just going to fuck him every time because the cops are obviously getting their gear every time without having to pay for it. They're obviously going to be the superior class until people actually can make enough money to buy the loadouts. And last time, actually, I think it's like 150K for me to buy a Katiba loadout with vest, backpack, clothing, you know, all my ammo, all that kind of stuff. And if we look to raise that, I'm going to be doing a hell of a lot of runs.
Oh yeah,
yeah. But you do have,
that's a difference.
Getting to do it,
right? That's the mindset that I think you have to get away from, of you doing a lot of runs. You doing 20 runs versus your gang doing 3, and everybody making more money or making the same amount of money in a third of the time, because you're doing it as a gang. Trust me. The first time you do it as a full gang and you roll up to one of the processors and there's six Hemets sitting there, and each, you know, two of the Hemets have the different let's say you're doing crystal meth, you know, it takes three deals. Two Hammets have phosphorus, two Hammets have ephedra, two Hammets have lithium, and everybody has their role of what they have to get out and what they have to process at a time and stuff like that. It so starts weeding out the gangs that are just that just formed a gang because they had the money and clicked create gang. You know, right. It starts putting the gangs up there that actually want to be gangs and actually have a structure. And I mean, when we were Bionic back in the days, we actually had times where we loaded up multiplayer servers on the side and actually went into training as a gang just so we could go back on Alpha's Life and use those strats against the other gangs, against the APD that we learned when we had weekly trainings as a gang, because it was worth it.
I think you have a point. You do have a valid point, I think, on the police, but I also feel like with that situation where if the police are powerful at the beginning, it might be worth it for the gangs. We have a group system now. The gangs can form group alliances and then fight the cops, piss the cops off, whatever, make sure that they don't get that foothold. You got to work together in that situation. I think that will help gangs and people work together to fight the cops instead of just, you know, bitching about it.
Oh, yeah.
The thing I'm thinking about, though, is with if it does come down to that, we still got the cartels. That's going to be raking in money of people trying to sell their drugs and everything, too.
Yeah,
I mean, you're going to have a big, massive gang fund to go get your big loadouts to be able to go and fight.
Yeah, and that's your other incentive, too, to go do that so that you can, you know, maybe you don't want to do a huge run, so you go take the cartels and have other people do the runs. You know, that works out, too. I think that's just yet another thing that a gang will be able to do to make money on the side or whatever.
Yeah. And Rogue brings up the good point of the big gangs get bigger kind of point, you know. He's talking about the big gangs will still be the dominant ones, but that's when it comes down to where you, like McDilly was saying, you have the smaller gangs actually form alliances to fight the bigger ones. Because we had that. The server that we came from, there was one, I mean, their server one was controlled by one gang, and it actually took us allying with another gang, and we actually ended up pretty much running them off the server. You know, so in my opinion, it promotes the more civ on civ, to where the gangs actually, you know, all the little gangs get pissed off at the one big gang that's ruling everything, you know. So it gives them the incentive to work together.
Yeah, like I said, in theory, I like it. You know, you keep bringing up the fact that rolling up to, you know, a processor with all these Hemets there, that's gonna be so far ahead if you actually wipe the economy. Because obviously, I think the point of doing this economy adjustment is to do a server wipe. There's no way you're going to adjust the economy and then not wipe it. It wouldn't make any damn sense.
Right.
That's not saying it's confirmed. You know, let's
it's not.
Yeah.
But I said myself the other day on my stream, I would be surprised if it doesn't happen.
Yeah. With the work going into it, I would be surprised if it didn't happen as well. In theory, I like it. I like having more gang fights. I like that people can actually work together if they want to. I think that it's just going to be a huge struggle from once the wipe happens to when people can actually afford the vehicles that they would need to actually make, you know, decent money doing runs with their, you know, their gang. Do you know if he's looking to increase prices on vehicles as well, or like, do you have any info regarding it?
I think he's looking at doing it across the board. Though what I think, and we had talked about this the other day, the Civ vehicles, which are going to be pretty much anything you buy from the regular car shop, and possibly I think just the Hummingbird. They might get a little increase, but that's about it. It's not going to be anything huge. Anything you buy from the truck shop, any of the Rebel vehicles, and then the bigger helicopters, those are all going to get a little bit more significant bump.
Good.
So, but I know the Civ stuff's going to get a little bump, but not a huge bump, in compared to the other stuff.
Okay. And I think... Continue.
I was just going to say, I know that there was some talk about, you know, cops and their gear and stuff, but I actually hope that the cops have to start from square one, just like the Rebels, where even though I'm a sergeant, I kind of would like to just, you know, have a PL7 and 25K and just have to deal with it, you know, and work that out and figure it out. And hopefully, like I said, with everything being more expensive, I actually really hope the bounties also get less, like, that they're worth less in comparison to bring that down for the cops as well, because killing someone for 40K when that's a backpack full of cocaine about in that situation, Yeah, that's one manslaughter. I would hope that that gets brought down to, like, you know, quite significant. I would hope the bounties, all the bounties get brought down to, like, 75% of their original value as well.
Well, I think he is going to work on the whole where cops don't get as much of the bounty, depending on what happens, depending on lethal versus ticketing versus jail.
Yeah, I swear that off of what I sent him. Yeah, no, I sent him, when he talked about the economy adjustment this morning, I literally sent him a thing. I was like, this is what you should do if people go to jail. Charge them this. This is what you should do if cops lethal somebody. Yeah, we talked about it before. We said 50%. If you go to jail, you pay 50% of your ticket. Regardless, this way you still save money. And, you know, you still got to do the time and all that. We said cops should get 50% for jailing somebody. Same for if they ticket them. Just leave it at, you know, an even 50. And then if they're lethal someone, I think they should just get 10%. Just get some little smidge of crap that they get for lethaling the person. Because I'm always the person that will advocate that lethaling should be final option. As much as everyone wants everyone to start with lethals, the whole point of it should be bringing criminals in, not taking them out. So
yeah,
right.
So 10% I think would be the good point right there. And cops would stop making so much money. I think with the if a wipe happens and the economy gets an adjustment, civs will stop having these high bounties unless you run into, you know, Jake from State Farm, the RDMer. no, that's not a real person either. Just grabbed an
information. That is a real person.
Actually, it's a real person.
There is a person named that.
Not you, Jake from State Farm, you know.
But,
random person here.
I don't even think the 10% should happen. I think if a cop lethals a criminal, their bounty should be wiped, but I don't think the cops should get any money for it.
I agree. I don't think the cops should get any money. I like it that way.
Yeah. The reason I say that is because that I know Poseidon's a real proponent about this, and I am too, about unwanted or unnecessary extra money in the economy. So,
yeah.
And the reason I say it like that is, like when you said, if a criminal gets put in jail, he has to pay the 50%. Well, that's what the cop gets. He only gets 50% of the bounty. You know, if he pays the ticket, to me, it's all about we're trying to make sure the economy stays pure.
You keep
and killing somebody and just getting 10%. Well, the criminal doesn't lose that money. He just loses the bounty, and the cop gets free money. I mean, that's the reason why we're changing the prison system. That's the reason we're doing what we're doing with the rocks. I don't know if y'all know anything about that, but we're actually going to code in to whenever, let's say a criminal gets put in there and he's in there for 2 hours, he has the option to pay for his bail and get out early if he wants to, or they're actually going to be able to open, it's the same dome set up like it is right now, but they're going to be able to open those garage doors on the sides, and there's rocks out in a yard out there, and they'll actually be able to go out there and mine the rocks, process the rocks inside. It looks like the thing that's on the back of a Tempest, the Tempest device.
Oh, gotcha.
They can process the rocks there, and then they turn them into a vendor there, and it doesn't give them money for it. It's not like, you know, there's another server where you can go stamp license plate and you make money. We don't want to put money in the economy
this.
So you go turn the rocks in, and it knocks minutes off of your time.
That's awesome.
So that's what we're going to do. Just eliminates people from just going AFK and waiting their 2 hours, you know. They're actually still doing something.
Going back on the whole lethal thing, I could see where people are going to want to be lethaled more than have to pay half their ticket to go to jail. I mean, they're going to try to put themselves in that position, though,
right,
to get lethaled.
Well, then, you know what? Then they should do this. If you still want to pay the cop the 10%, then if you get lethal, you lose that much out of your bank.
Yeah, I agree. Sure.
So 10% of your bounty. The whole point of lethals is for wiping the bounty. It's supposed to be because it's supposed to be a new person, right? Is that the purpose of it?
Yeah. If you get killed by the cops, that's why your bounty's wiped. But in my opinion, if that happens and you do get killed by a cop, you still lose 10. Let's say you lose 10% of your bounty, or just some arbitrary number. But it combats that. Yeah.
But it still doesn't go to the cop. That would be cool.
Yeah, so cops get nothing, civs get charged, you know, X percent, and that way they're still paying a fee for dying, and they're, you know, avoiding situations. I'm just ready for everyone to start getting, like, lethal by the cops when they run them over by accident, and then they start losing money because they have to pay these fines.
Well, until the if you look at the latest release log, he re-enabled VDM.
No VDMs.
No VDMs.
Yeah. Is that when you, like, you ragdoll and crap? Is that what it does right now? Yeah.
Yeah.
You just keep running people back and forth over and they just keep ragdolling on the ground?
I guess.
I just want to die.
Just kill me now. Anything that you guys think that we should do for drug weight, drug pricing, food pricing, anything like that to help, I guess, make people pay more? I mean, like, I'm all for people having to pay more for food and water not doing as much. That way it's like those little tiny things they still pay more for. It's like, what, $9 right now for a bottle of water that gives you 100?
Mm-hmm.
Like, I think a small thing like that, from changing the amount you get for it and then just raising the price a little bit to like $100 instead. You know, this way people are still paying a little bit of money, but it's not a significant amount where it's going to break the bank. You know.
Well, I don't know. I think I agree that there should always be one of the things that is being addressed in this economy update, especially, is like money sinks. There should always be more money sinks. And like Gendrek said, money coming out of thin air for no reason doesn't make any sense, and it only inflates the market.
Mm-hmm.
Where if you have a bunch of money sinks, especially like some sort of random gambling thing that you might be able to do, like just a random idea, like that would be really cool, you know, because then people would actually spend their money on stuff just for random stuff, you know. You maybe get lucky, but most of the time you don't, or something like that. You know, you never know. Maybe you want a 50 cal for, like, you know, just a pool of 50k. You never know. That could be like something. But the point I'm trying to make is that, yeah, there should be money sinks. I think if you change the weight of drugs, that might be a little bit too excessive, considering we're already lowering the price that you make from it. So if you also make it way more, then that's probably going to be excessive. That's when you're probably going to get into a grind fest, in my opinion. Now, with what you were talking about, Red Go Water, stuff like that.
Yeah.
I'm kind of with you. I mean, if it's still going to be like insignificant, I don't really like water and bacon. Bacon's $75. When do you ever pay $75 for like a meal? You
know what I mean? Bacon, though. Bacon's
quality.
The meal.
Yeah, it's quality.
I think the price should stay the same. The time it takes for your hydration and your food should go. I think it should go down faster.
That's true, because I noticed that when I play, a lot of the times I don't have to buy food and water, because usually I'm either going to die before it actually gets to that time, or like the server reset or something.
Right.
And I feel like, doesn't Red Gold give you 100 as well for water?
Mm-hmm.
Like, I like the idea of it giving you more energy, but I think it needs to lower the amount of water it gives you. That way, you know, it's not going to quench your thirst like actual water would.
Oh,
know?
Yeah. Yeah.
So. I think Red Gold is too powerful, in my opinion. I think what should happen is it gives you this energy boost, but it'll give you maybe a temporary boost to your hydration, but in the long run, I think it should decrease your hydration. Like, you get a boost to it, but then you start losing your hydration faster for the period of time that you have more energy.
Oh, like, so, you have a crash?
Yeah, exactly, like a crash. Like a
sugar
crash. That's a good idea. That's a good idea.
Yeah, that would be really cool, because then there's a risk to using Red Gold all the time. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you have this amazing shot, but it's like people used to take drugs like penicillin and shit like that to like increase their accuracy and their focus or whatever, like back in the day when they were used rifles, like snipers and stuff like that. But that's all that would come at a risk to them. You know, they could form an addiction, have problems with withdrawals, et cetera, et cetera. So I think that would be really neat. Matter of fact, that would be cool if all the drugs had, well, not all of them, not like marijuana, but, you know, maybe cocaine could make you like run faster, but then, like, I don't know, you get some sort of risk afterwards. That would
be a possibility of getting addicted to it or something going on,
and then have problems like all like Fallout-esque little addiction and withdrawals. That would be pretty neat.
Have a purpose to using drugs, although you get that upside, you still get that downside. Instead of just smoking marijuana in the square just to see how many cops you can get to go after you for it.
Exactly, because right now drugs are just for no reason. All they are is market value. I think it would be really cool if there was actually effects to using drugs, like you said, that just positive effects that had potential negative drawbacks. I think that would be really awesome.
Dependencies. I mean,
right? People might
don't
actually
take it. This is going to happen.
Exactly. That would be really awesome. Plus, the cops would probably find it on people more often.
Well, because I know. Yeah, it would. Write this stuff down, buddy.
I know, yeah, no doubt. So Wee King just, I don't know if Wee King is watching the stream, but he just TS chatted me. What do you guys think if you got charged for gas?
I say yes. I brought this idea before. This is how I would want it to work. Ideal situation. Okay, you drive your car up into the pump. A little thing pops up on the top, shows you how much you're paying for whatever you however much gas you're getting, and you can just drive off and it charges your bank.
Mm-hmm.
Not kind of like get out kind of crap. Like just you pull up, charges you, you leave.
It would be also really cool if, similar to the market, you have like a minimum and a maximum price for the gas in relation to the oil. And how many people have sold and done.
I like that too.
If oil is maxed out, you have the minimum gas price. Or like, not if oil is maxed out, but if, let's say, oil on the market is at its minimum because there's an oversaturation of oil, gas prices are also at their minimum price because there's so much of it. They have a lot of supply and not enough demand. That would be super really... That would be badass.
Yep. I'm going to write all that down.
Yeah, this way the market stuff actually affects everything else. We're sort of like going through, okay, we want to have this, and this has got to affect 10 different things, and then we're going to go with this, and it makes a more in-depth system, I think. And
yeah.
No one does oil unless they want that quick mill. I think oil's fun to do. I like mixing stuff up. I mean, obviously, if you do like copper and all that kind of crap, you're doing the same thing technically, whereas you're driving that bomb on wheels, there's a little bit more risk involved to getting your money.
You could have situations like that. You can think of all kinds of situations like copper, stuff like that. Maybe copper could influence the prices of certain weapons that are metal-based, like, I don't know. You know what I mean? Maybe you could use that for iron.
I'd say yes, but my guns from Rebel get imported from just the finest places around the world, so...
That's right.
All of my guns are made out of plastic, so I can sneak them through the...
Yeah, they're all made in my little 3D printer.
There you go.
What are you going to do, right? What else could we change? I mean, I'm sure there's more to change the economy of how you can better it. I'm pretty much out of ideas regarding it, though.
It's all about change. I mean, like McDilly said, there's so much stuff that I want to add to the server that would cost. I mean, like, I want to build a trampoline that you actually pay. You pay, you go in there, you jump on it, it shoots you way up in the air, and then you get parachute. Just stuff that... I know that sounds dumb, but people will pay it just because if they get bored.
If you look, I just linked in the TeamSpeak and in this chat a screenshot of one of the versions of the new map. And I don't know if everything's still the same, though the war zone isn't in this picture. But I was wondering, what do you guys think about the placements of... I wanted to talk about the placements of the processors. Like I noticed, for instance, cocaine processing, heroin field, Moonshine Brewery, they're all very close to the Rebel outposts. And I'm curious what the intention is here. I'm actually just really curious to know the design behind it all and everything like that. So, Jindrak, if you will.
Which Rebel outpost in particular? I mean...
Well, for instance, in the Northeast, you have cocaine processing, which is really close to the Northeast Rebel outpost. Rebel outpost above Athira is like a kilometer or so away from the heroin field. And the Moonshine Brewery is not
literally
far from
right on the other side of DP6.
Yeah, that's 2.5 kilometers away. I checked it, but
yeah, it's very close.
Well, yeah.
I'm just curious,
but people don't
that's
also
to promote Civ on Civ.
Yeah, that's true.
That's the deal. It's what I'm trying to do. I'm not that I'm trying to save the cops from anything, but.
I'm not trying to say you are.
I know you're not. To me, it's the way it always looks like is Rebel on Rebel, Civ on Civ, however you want to place it. There's a fun aspect when you think about that. When you think about Civ on Cop, people don't say it like that. People say trolling the cops.
Right.
You don't ever say trolling the Civs when it's Civ on Civ. It's Civ on Civ, gang on gang, or it's trolling the cops. So to me, that promotes more civ on civ. Is the only reason to do that.
The biggest question is: did you change these penis arrows?
Yeah, this is an old one. This is I did because you called me out on my stream, so I changed it. Yeah, this is an old map because it's got the penis arrows on there.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. What else on here?
Man, I didn't realize they looked like that until I see it in this form. Oh. So yeah.
Penis arrows, is what they are. I never realized there was so many turtle poaching areas. Jesus Christ. Did you add more of them on, or...?
No. Well, I put... There was always only just, what, the like one by Kavala and one by Pygros. you can turtle poach anywhere.
Yeah,
if there is a turtle in the water, you can shoot it and take it. So that's honestly, that was just me saying, hey, you can turtle poach anywhere. It's just a place where people can go, where cops can go and actually catch somebody in the act, because it's an illegal area. And it gives them probable cause for being in the illegal area, but you can do it anywhere.
I always wondered, do turtles spawn more there, or just an icon?
Literally just a marker on the map.
I'm not going there anymore, though. I'm just going to go
turtles
to, like,
spawn anywhere.
All you got to do is go right off the coast, shoot a couple turtles, go in, sell it.
But
now you got to go to Rape. Now you got to go to Rape Island and sell the turtles, though. So,
which is fine. Yeah. The island's actually being used. I was really hoping there was a house on there. You could just live on
the
island.
There is houses on there, but they're not viable. They're all trashed.
Yeah, not viable houses.
It's actually good, because what people would do is just sit on the coast and fill a Hemet up with turtles, and then they'd go to the turtle dealer. So now you can't do that, because you're not getting a Hemet on that island.
Now there's a reason to buy a boat and get a trunk upgrade, and there's more boat spawns. Yeah. You know, I added more boat shops around the map, so.
Yeah, that's actually really useful.
Hmm?
I'm just looking at the map right now, figuring out what's where. I haven't actually, like, seriously, like, stared at this map before.
Oh, yeah.
I noticed the new prison isn't moved either, yeah.
I was going to say, is this...
Hmm?
Yeah, this is an old one. The prison hasn't been moved yet in this map.
Oh, yeah. I don't know if a lot of you guys have checked out where it is, but it is super all straight up by where the lithium mine is currently on the current map.
Baseball diamond building.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It is super awesome. I've checked it out, and that place is going to be way more fun to fight in than the current jail. Yeah. Way more fun.
Oh, yeah.
Multiple entrances is the big key there.
Yeah. And I love the tower. There's a tower that's across the way just outside the walls that has perfect line of sight on the door. It's these key strategical points, but also plenty of cover to move around in throughout the base. That's what I like about it a lot. It's really going to be awesome.
It gives a lot of opportunity for ambush on both sides.
Yeah, that's what I love.
Instead of just sitting on top of a dome and hoping that people don't hit you from their...
Oh, yeah. and just having to watch one bridge, you know, and that's it.
I hated those towers, dude. Like, those towers pissed me off. Because, like, I never knew where I was getting shot from, like, if I was playing Cop or playing on Civ. Like, they always get those little towers, and I can never actually see them from that distance. I don't know if I'm blind as shit or something, but I hated those towers. Lithium mine, oil field, diamond mine.
Yeah, this is an old picture.
Chop shop. Is there only two chop shops?
And I'm going to pull up the game and actually get a new picture.
Yeah, get us a new picture. Discuss this new map instead of this, whatever this is.
I'm going to say, yeah, right now, let's see, you asked about the chop shops. Yeah, there's only two.
No, there's three. Kavala, Airfield,
Airfield and Sophia, yeah.
I don't know,
that's never been discussed if we need more.
I like
one
more.
Pyrgos? I would like one somewhere on the Pyrgos side, in the southeast, that would be nice. Or maybe, actually, it would be a good idea to have one up by the, in the war zone when that comes out, because then... You know,
fuck that, dude. I'm gonna go find an RDM zone to get my chopper shot out that I just stole from.
No, but like people that are fighting in the war zone, in the war zone, and then they go there.
I'd stick it by where it says a cowl, whatever that says, under Frog Factory. What is that place?
Frog Factory. Where did I put Frog Factory? Oh, the cow manure field.
Yeah, what's above that? Is that like a hill or some shit? Oh, that's where my house is. Yeah. Never mind. You don't want to put it there. My house is
that's default. Yeah, that's a built-in city. Yeah.
I got a bungalow up there. Never mind. You don't want to put it there. but somewhere in that, you know, that bottom section of the map, I wish we had a fourth one. Or even if you move the one that's by Airfield, like, up more, and then put another one down there, I don't know. Four is better than three. Just like every air shop needs a garage.
They have that. Well, this map is old.
You're welcome.
You're just calling out stuff that was your idea so I can give you credit on the podcast.
Yeah.
Yes, I'm yes. The Northeast Airfield is
Airfare.
Is his idea.
Confirmed.
He wants to call it Airfare. And the garages at him is his idea as well. So.
I don't know what else I added. You know, map redesigned by Warfare. You're welcome.
The non-penis arrows.
I don't have any more topics. We literally blew through all of them.
I want to talk. There's, I don't know if this is controversial. Let me know, Jindrak, if it is. But one of the things we didn't talk about last week that I actually did want to talk about, who are your favorite permaband players that you miss? And I'm going to start mine.
That's not controversial.
I don't know if any of you know Conan the Destroyer. I love that guy, but, I mean, he definitely deserved the ban, but that guy was just so hilarious, and his RP was so funny. Every time I had an encounter with him, it was just the funniest encounter. It was never a dull moment to him. But he was the type of person that would be like, you know, hey, man, you want to play some baseball? And he'd be, like, throwing chem lights back and forth with, like, a medic and a bunch of people. And then he'd be like, all right, I'm going to throw this one deep. And then he'd throw a frag grenade and kill six people. Like, and it was RDM, you know, well, but
no,
it was...
No so wonder fun. He got banned.
Yeah.
Here's my frag. I don't really have any perm ban players. Like, I play with Diggy, who got banned perm ban for harassment. And, like, I like the guy. But I've never actually, like, played Altus with him. So I don't know if he's, like, would be, like, a favorite for me or anything like that. I don't really have friends that are permanently banned. So.
Yeah, I was going to say, you're... Coming from my shoes, the only permaband people I remember are people that I assigned them to. You know, I assigned them. So.
Right.
That guy's been.
I don't have any favorite ones because I hated all of them. That's why I permed them.
Hey, McDilly, you don't know the hotkey for that program, do you?
What program?
The one that makes those screenshots pretty much instantly. Gaizo or however you call it.
I don't think it has a hotkey for it, does it? I don't think
I've heard it. I bookmarked this. Someone else, Tony, is the one who took that screenshot. I bookmarked it, the link.
Was it F12 in game for Steam ticket picture?
Wow. Yeah, but I cut off my Steam overlay because I was having Steam ticket check failed stuff.
Oh, well, rip.
Hang on, I'll figure it out.
You should have somebody that's like a map designer or something take a screenshot.
Yeah. Well, so since I guess we're coming up to the end of everything, we can bring up. What?
I don't have any topics, so you know, if you guys have final topics to discuss, bring them forth. I have obviously the doc that has them all in there, but I mean, I don't know if any of the stuff we'd want to talk about. A lot of them is kind of Jesus Christ.
Yeah. There, I know that we were talking about. I know we used to have a cop of the week. We could do that as well as a civ of the week, as well as a medic of the week.
How about just a player of the week?
Player of the week? I agree with that.
Player of the week. I have not played this whole week, so go forth.
I actually have... I got a new job, so I've been working a lot. I haven't Jesus actually played Christ. For a
while. Look, I'm telling you, yeah, it's all the same way. You can look at my ARMA time on Steam, and the past 2-3 weeks, all of the minutes in Steam have been in the editor. Wow. I've actually been on a live server in probably at least 3 weeks.
Okay, Ham, who actually plays, do you have a player of the week, whether it be cop, medic, or civ, that you thought did a great job in some way, shape, or form?
No comment, because I'm biased, but I will say a big congratulations to someone in just a second.
Who?
To what?
I don't know. I have no idea.
Gucci!
Oh, Gucci!
All right, Gucci got corporal, didn't he?
Yes, he did. Mm-hmm. He deserved it.
Oh, cool.
And then James got R&R coordinator. I saw that.
I did see that. That happened an hour ago or so. What? Yeah, that was. Yeah, he did.
He's got R&R.
Finally replaced me.
That's. Well, he deserved it. I think he's he takes it pretty seriously. I think.
Oh yeah, yeah. No, there's awesome. That's.
Yeah. That's coming from a dispatch, though. I'm just a little dispatch.
That's my baby. There's always a special heart in the medic system for me, but then again, I designed it, so.
Right.
By the way, with the medics thing, did you ever figure out a way to skin the Taru?
Yes, actually, I was about to answer Chrono's question. He was just asking an update on the medic. The only thing update that I have right now, at least from a design standpoint, is I learned that Bohemia actually released an ARMA 3 tools that you can download separately. It's like a whole, it's not a game, separate game, but it has everything available to me. So I can download that. So I now have the skins for the Tarus and the Hurons for all the DLC. So, yeah. Oh, sorry. Crone. She.
She.
See? Busted.
Busted.
Yeah, dude. Anyway, yeah, I'm gonna be skinning the Taru for the medics for sure. And then I'm gonna look at skinning something rebel based for the Huron, possibly.
Isn't it already camo?
So
that'd be awesome. Yeah.
Yeah. So something Olympus rebel based. So
yeah, you got the picture. It's a crappy picture, but it's a picture.
It's,
for what?
It's viewable. The map.
The map.
Oh, okay. Awesome.
Let's see.
It's a little cluttered because there's quite a bit.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Oh, no, my.
You put enough stuff on this map, Gendrak? Jesus Christ. I mean, look how big
Holy
that maximum
crap.
Security penitentiary little icon is. That thing's huge.
Oh, look at the gang.
That's got to be resolution or something, man.
This has to be resolution.
It does not look like that on mine.
It is.
What do you play, 800 by 600, Moose?
No, that's 16 by 9, but I'm in windowed.
Oh, my God.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
That is terrible. Cause
you look at the map and you just don't even know
where.
Yeah,
you're like, where's where?
Let me put it in 2715 by 1527.
Oh, that'll be a good picture. That'll be
yeah,
a good
it will.
If it'll. Oh, my God. It extends over into my other monitor. Can't do it.
Nope. Never mind. Warbill. Yeah, look at those Warstone names.
But the. Anyway, Chrono, the timer. The timers, yeah, Poseidon will get, he's getting that added back in. The release timers, so medics have time to get to you.
Oh, thank goodness.
That's
something
that
so
he,
good.
Yeah, he rolled back, a long time ago, he rolled back one patch, coding patch, and he forgot to put that back in, so.
What are we talking about? What timer?
Whenever you do request medic.
Oh, I had a timer before?
Yeah, it. Because right now it's, you know, 30 seconds and you respawn.
Uh-huh.
Whenever you did request medic, it increased your respawn timer to 3 minutes.
We don't want it to do that?
So, we do want it to do that. It's not doing it anymore.
Oh.
It did it for a while, and then when he rolled back a patch, he forgot to put it back in.
Just make it like 10 minutes, that way people can actually leave.
Honestly, I think it needs to be at least 5, if not 10 minutes.
But the problem is that, though, is you could be like me who gets left in the fucking desert and no one ever comes for you, and you're just forever sitting there waiting for that medic to come. Who is forever at the airport somehow. I don't know how he did
it. It's one of those things with the new... When the economy gets redone and people don't have a lot of money, if you've got a Katiba layout for $150,000 and you've only got $200,000 to your name, you're going to, regardless of the timer, you're going to wait for that medic to come get you to save your money.
Yeah, if we're talking about, you know, new economy, is that what we're talking about?
Yeah.
He posted a picture.
There's Rogue asked about the, he heard news of certain skins for certain players. How's that going to work? Donation purchase, something like that. Yeah, that's how, with the database system right now, even with whitelisted slots, cop slots, medic slots, we can go as staff, we can go into the database and assign levels. And then that's how it knows which slots you can get into, what gear you have access to, like the cops and ranking system like that. We will be able to set with like the because right now, even with the donation ranks, you know, depending on which level donator you are, whenever you go to the vendor, you see certain gear. We're going to now have slots for, say, the community team to where you can just do it either an on or off. And if it's on, whenever they go to the vendor, they're going to have access to the press gear without having to mess with whitelisted slots. We are going to do that.
When do we get our top 20 skins, okay? You know, like a little hatchback skin that says,
I was on top 20.
Yeah.
That's all up to Poseidon, man. That's coding. That's coding.
So we can all have our little cute skin and remind us of the good old days when I could suicide bomb everybody and it wouldn't matter to me.
Yeah, yeah, oh yeah. See, that screenshot looks better.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I pulled it up just now, too.
Way better. That's awesome. So this is the newest map.
I'm so glad the gun store is removed. Like, I think that's going to cut down on so much of, like, crap RDM, and especially Kavala, because they're not going to be able to just, you know, instantly spawn in and go grab a gun. They have to run their ass all the way over to Neri.
Oh yeah, and it's a good run to get. It's a good run over there to Neri too.
Oh.
So it's not like it's 200 meters away. You know, it's a decent run to get over there.
Yeah, that's going to be awesome, to be honest.
And it's good to know that Poseidon got that baby dick.
Plus that, plus that the whole if you combat log while restrained, or if you log out while restrained, you have the skeleton there, so you can send it to jail. And anybody can, not just the cops, but anybody can go up to it and send him to jail, because he was restrained, he logged out of the game, he shouldn't have done it. So I guess they're... That's awesome.
I like the concept, but I feel like 99% of the people that combat log, they do it the second they're tased. There's no chance to ever restrain them. So,
I wish that's how it's going to be.
I think he said they have to be restrained in order for it to actually do the whole skeleton crap. Do you know, Jendrek?
Yeah.
I know that's what he said in the stream the other day, but I guarantee you if him doing this doesn't really alleviate any problem and it shows that it is that way, you know, Tay's combat log, he'll change it.
Okay. Because that's the only thing I think should be changed. Like, everyone that combat logs on me, it's always I tase him and they just leave. It's like, all right.
So yeah.
That would be great if that could be fixed on that. Did he add any new stuff to the event menu yet? Because we got the event thing down here. I know he had the racing one. And what else was it? There was two of them, right?
Yeah, there's the Kavala Derby, there's the Grand Derby, and then there's races leaving Kavala, and there's races leaving Pygros. So he will add the Last Man Standing stuff.
And then Ghost Hawk battles.
The deal is, with the new event system, we could do that.
Because you can delete the vehicles, right?
All of the vehicles are tied to the event system, and I can repair them, I can delete them, I can heal all of the participants, I can feed and water all the participants.
There is a gun store, Bubba at Sophia. You can't really tell, but if you see where it says taxi department, right underneath that it says gun store. If you're wondering. Rogue said we could also do a community competition where we could add skins in... That's you, not me. I don't know. Reach out.
Like community design. Honestly, there was one individual that was on the server for a while that made a skin that I liked. I reached out to him. I said, "Hey, you want to mock me up some skins?" I was kind of going to pull in an assistant designer. And then he had some RL stuff come up, and he hadn't been back.
He was never heard from again.
Never heard from again. So that was Razor. I don't know if you guys saw the Poseidon truck that he made. I'm not against having an assistant designer. I would definitely, like I said, the last 3 weeks I've been designing, having played the game. So I would love to get some things off my plate so I could actually get back on the servers and do some stuff. But, I'm not against that. I'm not against somebody stepping up and trying to help me out with designing stuff.
Yeah, that would be pretty cool, because... I mean, you already do so much work as it is, and it's really awesome. Definitely starting to show. Can't wait till this next update's going to be so huge, dude.
Oh, yeah.
How about that news van?
Just get ready to...
I think I have a picture of that on hand. Let me see.
You can show off the...
I have the original one you sent me without the actual colors on it. Just the old-ass logo and shit.
This one on the forums.
Oh, yeah, I posted on the forums.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that thread doesn't...
Blue one. Oh, it doesn't? Oh.
Mm-hmm.
No, that thread doesn't exist anymore.
Yeah.
Final topic? Anything? We got anything?
Warfare, I don't know if you... Do you have any system set up where you could randomize... just randomly pick a name in the chat?
I don't currently know.
Oh. Okay.
Why?
Never mind. Oh, well, I was going to do one of them $10 giveaways and donate for somebody to have some $10 perks, you know?
Send them in my chat and I can do a giveaway.
Oh, you can?
Yeah, they got to be in my chat, though.
Oh, okay.
I've got a deep bot. I got deep bot.
I'm going to have you talk to Warfare, but...
Yeah, I mean that's up to anybody that wants to do it. I'm gonna post your link in the chat.
Yeah.
Yeah, Ham, post in the chat, if you can send me a private message in TeamSpeak, I'll send you like $10 in PayPal, and then we'll do that a giveaway on your channel.
All right.
There you go.
So, like I said, guys, Ham and Moose, go to his Twitch. It's been typed in the chat twice now. We're gonna do a $10 giveaway. So it's gonna be a donation giveaway. You'll get donated $10 perks. So if you don't have it already, I want to stick around for that.
Yeah, and then if you have, obviously, I guess 90, you would go to 100, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera.
Yeah, if you don't have, you know, even if you don't have 10, if you already have $10 perks, but maybe you don't have 25, maybe you don't have 50, it'd be another step up towards getting closer to that goal. So,
if you're interested, go to Ham's chat, and if you're not, then, well, rip. And if you're
thanks for joining the podcast.
I guess that was really just it. So head over to the chat, guys, and do that up. I appreciate everyone coming on. Sadly, Clemenza didn't get to make it, so we'll have to get him on another time as well. Jendrak, thanks for coming on, man. You know, it helps with getting, you know, the questions everyone has, we can get them answered, and it helps out a lot with everything, so we can have other sides to other stories. And I appreciate you coming on. We're going to have you on again, obviously, when you make the time for it. And then Mr. Moose, thank you for coming on too, buddy. Appreciate it. So you're more than welcome to come on again as well.
It was very fun, actually.
It worked out really well. So if you guys have any questions, type in the chat. I'll be here afterwards, and I'll answer whatever I can. If you need to watch the previous part of this episode, I'll have it up on YouTube, hopefully either tonight or tomorrow, as long as everything goes to plan. And I will we'll all see you guys next week.
Yep.
Thanks for having me.
All right, now we need to sit here and talk mad crap. No.